Mr. Chairman had soon found himself another engine for the Dark Railway Preservation Society. His name was Goose, and, well, he's a bit special. Mr. Chairman had fallen over at the chance to purchase a unique tank engine for the society, and had wished him to the railway as soon as he could. Along with Goose, Mr. Chairman had acquired a pair of lovely auto coaches for him to work with. On his first day in service, Goose, along with the coaches, reported for duty at Axley, where Chairman was waiting excitedly.
Oh, how quaint. It's been such a long time since last seeing a proper auto train. I remember watching them down on the Kingsbridge branch line back in the 1950s. Oh, those were the days.
Never worked there, dude. Worked at Brantwell, innit?
Oh, well, never mind that. You look splendid, Goose. Now then, you'll be operating the branch trains today. Is that all right with you?
I suppose.
Splendid! Well, I'll see you when you get back, then.
And with that, Goose reversed out of the station, propelling his coaches up the line. The journey up the branch was uneventful, but Goose did enjoy the scenery the line offered. He soon arrived at Soma, where Andy was waiting to take some ballast wagons away.
Yo Goose, how did you find the run up here, mate?
It's an alright little branch line, I guess. Bit short though, and I did think the track was a bit wobbly, especially over that viaduct.
Yeah, it has its own charm, this line does. Shame the quarry seems to be winding down production though, and it's nowhere near as exciting as the main line up to Mearcombe. That's a thumping good run, that one.
Ooh, can't wait to have a look at that at some point.
In time, mate. Anyways, gotta run down the hill with these trucks. Won't be long. Then you'll have the path back to Axley.
Okie doke, my dude.
Once Andy was clear of the branch, Goose glided down the hill and back into the bay platform at Axley, where Mr. Chairman was waiting.
So how was your first day on the branch, Goose? It's a wonderful line, isn't it?
Boring. Can I go and do something else now, please?
Excuse me? No, of course not.
Oh. Why not?
Because your job is to operate the branch line passenger train, and the branch line passenger train only.
You mean there isn't, for example, some trucks I could go and shun, a goods train to take? Not even any seagulls to shite at?
Oh no, Mr. B's already tending to that.
Din jävla mågefan!
So you see, there's nothing else to do other than operate the branch line passenger train.
But this is boring though. I thought you'd brought me here as an all-purpose machine.
Oh no, quite the contrary. Your one and only job is to go up and down the Soma branch with the auto train. All day and every day.
You're joking.
Oh, I never joke.
So you're never going to let me go and do anything else?
Probably not, no. Besides, there isn't any other work for you. Your unique position as an auto-fitted tank engine.
But that's not fair. Just because I've got auto gear doesn't mean I can't go off and do any other...
Well, I'm afraid it does. You see, I've already got Andy and Abomination doing freight work, and Mr. B is more than capable of doing some shunting. And with the unique operational circumstances of the branch line, it means that an auto train really is the best solution for running the line, other than purchasing a diesel multiple unit, but that's not going to be happening anytime soon, obviously.
But...
I shall have no more discussion on this, Goose. Your next train leaves in an hour, so I want you to...
Wait, hold the fuck up. An hour?
Yes?
You want me to sit here doing jack-all for an entire hour?
Of course, what's the problem with that?
I literally just said that I'm bored. What am I supposed to do for an hour?
I don't really care. Do some train spotting or something. Anyway, I've got a dash. I just spotted in a business opportunity. I'll be seeing you later.
With that, Mr. Chairman hurried away, leaving Goose feeling incredibly cross. Goose was still fuming that evening when he returned to the junction.
That German kid, eh? He's a right bellend. Give me one job and one job only.
Alright, calm down, mate. Passenger work is nothing to be sniffed at. Better than pulling trucks.
But I used to do all sorts of jobs back on the Western region. Packs, shunting, goods, inspections and all that, right? And I come here, and that bozo assigns me one bloody job. And trundling up and down that short branch line all day is just so...
I happen to like the Soma branch, actually.
Same.
I want to do more than just potter up and down a hill at awkward intervals, though. I'm more than just an auto tank. That chairman has no idea how to properly utilise his assets. Seriously, I was treated better by British Railways, and that's saying something. At least I had the freedom to shunt between trains or help out with something else.
Aw, oh, come on, man. Chairman's not that bad.
Not that bad? Oh, but of course you'd say that. You're probably right there under his thumb.
I honestly don't see what you're complaining about, Goose. I mean, you're running passenger trains on an important and historic branch line. Isn't that enough for you? Most engines, including myself, would give all of their vivids to be considered for permanent passenger work.
Yeah, but you're mainly rostered as a shunter, aren't you?
Well, yeah, but I sometimes do trip freights and banking.
Exactly, a variety of jobs, and I'm stuck with just the one duty.
Look, Goose, I'm sure that soon, Mr. Chairman will let you do other work, but you just have to be patient. When I first got here, I thought the same as you. I was stuck as a banking engine on the old industrial branch at Mirkoon. But when that closed, I began doing other jobs. It's just a matter of time. Chairman will see that he can use you for other jobs too.
Oh, I don't think so. I've seen this type of character before, and they're all the same. They don't appreciate us properly. To the humans, we're just machines, here to do their bidding. So what if we have feelings? So what if we have our own desires and wants? That doesn't matter. Even though we're blessed with sentience, people like Chairman couldn't give a shit about how we actually feel, because we're dispensable. You diesel engines proved that when you arrived on the scene. As soon as diesels became widely spread, the Western region got rid of all their steam engines, and didn't even think twice about scrapping us.
A chorus of vulgar sounds greeted this, and the heated argument seemed inevitable. However, a familiar face had mysteriously drifted over to the engines.
Excuse me, Goose. Can I have a private word with you over here?
Yeah, okay.
Goose followed Mr. Chairman a short way away, still feeling slightly agitated.
Now, Goose, I hope you're not going around telling your new friends that I'm some sort of tyrant.
Oh no, I wasn't saying...
Because I most certainly am a tyrant, so listen here. I don't appreciate you upsetting the other engines like that. My engines do as they're told, and if I set them a task, I expect them to complete it without fuss. If you can't behave yourself, be the sensible, hard-working engine I expect, then I'm afraid I'll have no choice but to propose to the society that we sell you. Now, I'd rather not go down that road, but...
Go on, then.
I'm sorry, what?
Go on, then, sell me if you dare. You would just be proving my point that you humans couldn't give shit, number one, about us engines. I've lived long enough and seen enough to know that we're dispensable, and if I'm going to conform to your socialist administration and sacrifice my freedoms, then I'd rather be sold. Go on, then, Mr. Chairman. That is your real name. I fucking dare you.
Mr. Chairman was slightly taken back by this.
Now, Goose, you know that I don't really want to resort to that, right?
Oh, absolutely. That's why I'm giving you an ultimatum.
You're giving me an ultimatum?
Yep. Either you let me do work other than passenger ones, or I'll be, let's say, less cooperative from this point going forward.
Well then, I'm afraid I will not give in to threats, Goose. And I will not be told by one of my engines what I can and cannot do with them. Now, I purchased you for a specific job which plays to your strengths. And I will not, I repeat, I will not be pressured into pandering into your ridiculous demands.
Chairman stormed away, whilst Goose remained where he was, seething. Early the next morning, Mr. Chairman arrived at Axley, not altogether shocked to find that Goose was absent. However, he decided to wait around anyway, as he knew that Andy would soon arrive with the first empty ballast train bound for the quarry. However, half an hour went by, then an hour, and still there was no sign of Andy, nor Mr. B, nor Abomination. As passengers for the Soma shuttle began to mill around, Chairman ducked back to his car, determined to find out why the other engines had not shown up yet. Had Goose convinced them to strike, perhaps? Chairman hated the idea of this, and hurried away towards the junction to see what was what. But when he arrived, a bizarre sight greeted him. Goose was stood on the point, blocking access out of the shed. Mr. B was coupled to him, his engine revving hard.
Come on, Goose! This is hurting my gearbox! Move, man!
I'm nearly up to working pressure, Mr. B. I'll try and move him in a moment.
No, I ain't moving. You can't make me.
I can't move him! Av, get over here and move him!
Right, all of you, what's going on here?
Mr. B dropped his rev so he could hear Mr. Chairman.
Goose is refusing to move, sir. I've had this for a good 40 minutes now. I just can't get him to move. His brakes are hard on.
He came back over here last night raving about how he wasn't going to move until you gave in to his demands?
And I'd help, but the little bastard damaged my brake line, so I can't move either.
For goodness sakes, Goose! Are you genuinely that selfish? Would you rather jeopardize the entire society's operations rather than get over yourself and take a simple push-pull train?
I told you I'm not going to cooperate.
Well, in that case, I have no choice but to admit defeat.
Oh? Does that mean you'll let me do some shunting or something then?
Absolutely not! Once we get the others out of the shed, I'm going to leave you in the maintenance bay out of the way until you come to your senses and stop being a nuisance.
Well, you could sell me, like you said you would.
Oh, I don't think so. That would be too easy. I think I need to teach you a proper lesson here, Goose. Life is unfair, and we don't always get what we want. So, Abomination, when you have pressure, please could you shunt Goose over to the maintenance shed?
Okay, sir.
See? You just blindly follow orders. What is wrong with you?
More so, what is wrong with you? You're preventing us from doing our work, even though Mr. Chairman has been very patient and has been quite fair with you. Are you surprised that none of us are very impressed with your actions so far?
Whatever. You can't move me. You're just an austerity tank engine. Ha.
But Goose was mistaken. Abomination could, and did, eventually shunt Goose out of the way and into the maintenance shed. Though Mr. B was complaining about his gearbox aching, he was able to leave soon after. Lastly, Abomination took Andy over to the works to see if Buzz and Mr. Smash could fix his brake pipes. Mr. Chairman walked sternly over to Goose.
What are you going to do? Just leave me here.
Yes, Goose, that's exactly what I'm going to do, until you can come see sense and be reasonable.
Not going to happen.
Oh, we'll see.
Mr. Chairman headed back to his car to see what could be done about the current situation. Goose, showing no remorse at all, scowled as his owner disappeared from view.